Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. In this latest video from my HMS Victory Build series, which is issue 65, you're going to see me turn a standard dowel into the main yard of HMS Victory. Okay, so it's time to start working on the main yard. So this is the dowel, we're getting the latest instructions. And it sort of shows you how to make it all in one piece. Well, obviously you have to carve out the sling and build it in back in yourself. But I'm not too keen now to show you the instruction of it, it looks particularly very good. So what my plan is, I'm actually going to cut the sling out of a square box section of 8x8 and obviously carve the octagonal section into that. I think it'll be easier. Then I'm just going to cut the ends of the main yards off and then reattach them to the sling that I made. I just think it's going to look better, be easy to taper the ends as well. Okay, so let's get making a start. The dowel is pretty much about 400 mil, so obviously I'm just going to make some impression marks and oversize it. So these are the marks on the plan, so I'm just going to leave myself about 20 mil just to go into the tailstock of the lathe. So that's your impression mark that you need to start tapering the yard down. And I'm just going to give myself another 10-15 mil hanging over, and it's just going to go in the chuck. So I've just cut the yard to length, well, 7 mil dowel. I'm just looking at the plans, obviously for this section, this needs tapering first. I need 140 mil, so obviously I've just made two pencil marks. I'm just checking, yeah, obviously I've got 140 mil, and that's the part that I'm tapering. He's tapering down to 3 mil, and the furthest end I'm pretty much leaving at 7 mil on the far end. Okay, so I'll start tapering that down. Just shaking the drawer in, obviously looking at the iron for the studding sail boom, and I've just measured it. I think I need 67 mil. Yeah, 67 mil, so I've just made a mark on me yard. 67 mil. I need a distance of, need a distance of 5 mil. I can just keep using that. I still need 5 mil. At the minute, I'm still at 6, so I still need some more tapering. So that's literally only about 5 minutes is tapering. I'm just going to check all the indication marks now. I need 3 mil right on the tip. I said I made little indication marks all the way along what sizes I needed at different points. 5.1, 6 mil. And 7 still right at the end. 7.3. Yeah. Yeah. Just to show you just how quick and easy these little mini lathes are, turning the yards and the mass. And just look how much sod has come off. Okay. So just give this a quick clean up and move on to another stage. Okay, so I finished the first part of my yard. Obviously, that'll just be cut to length. I'll just leave that in so you get a little bit more to play with on the tailstock. And I've just reduced this down to 3 mil. And obviously, when I cut this to the sling, then obviously I'll use that too. I'll drill a 3.5 mil hole in the end of that, and I'm about to use it to join them up. Okay, I'm just going to cut another one of these. I won't do it on camera, you've seen me cut it already. Then I'm about to move on. Okay, so that's both mass tapered. That's it. Just got to cut the end off still. But I'll do that when I start making the slide-ins. Alright, so I'm going to fit the booms irons. I'm just going to put it back onto my drawing. And I've just marked two lines where the boom's going to line up. I'm just going to try the boom and see how far I get before I might need a little bit more tapering. Yeah, so as you can see, it's not far off, so all I'll do is I'd rather be able to leave a bit more material to tape it back rather than it come all the way back. So I'm just tape a bit more material off and hopefully. Okay, so I'm just tapered that down slightly a bit more, put it back under the drawing. Just highlighting the indication marks again a little bit more. And I'll try fitting the boom irons again. That's a lot better fit. I just drilled a 0.8 mil hole in the end. Just fit the other iron. Square them up. And that's ready to move on to the next stage. Okay, so it's time to work onto the octagonal sling. So I've got my mat, pencil and drum. So I've got my plans and mag. And so I'm going to mark, just measure and then mark on these. So the plans show me 92 mil. So I'm just going to get this 8 mil stock. I'm just going to mark it at the end there, because obviously none of these ends are flush. Start marking it for the octagonal sections. Okay, so I've just cut the stock to length and now I just need to mark it out for the parts I need to cut for the octagonal section. So this is 8BA, so I'm just using a scrap piece of 6 mil. I'm just going to put it onto the bottom, draw a pencil line. It over, do the same again. And that gives a centered 4 mil piece that we need. Just keep doing it all the way around, then we'll be able to shave off the corners to make the octagonal. So that's all marked up, and all we're going to do now is just start to shave off the corners. Save and sand them down and form a nice octagonal shape. Okay, so I'm just finished shaping the sling. And I think so far it looks the best one I've done. I'm just going to show you sometimes when you just do things your own way rather than following the instructions. It turns out a lot better. So all I'm going to do now is just slightly taper the ends, drill the holes inside, and then fit the two ends of the yards. The carved ends, all I'm using is a coffee stirrer you get from most places. I always tend to borrow a few because they're actually quite good for using for like little scraps of wood, of course. But they have quite a nice curved end, so I'm just going to put it on. Let's do the half circle. Move it around. And you get the nice tapered end to carve. Okay, so I've just tapered the end. Just carved it slightly. And then I'll just run it over with sandpaper just to try and bring in the little half circle curves. And I've just drilled the hole in the end. Just use drilled it 1.5 first and then moving up to 3mm. So that's what I tapered this. Just dialed down to 3mm. So I'm just going to bring the two parts together and see how they line up. Awesome. As you can see, I think all looks really good. Okay, I'll drill a hole for the next side. Okay, so I've just dry fitted the second part of the yard. None of these are lined up yet, only because it's a dry fit. But I think it's gone together really good. There's a little bit of twist on it, but obviously when I actually glue them together, I'll glue them on a nice straight edge. So obviously then I can just like obviously wedge that out and wedge the other end out and it'll dry nice and square. So okay, so yeah, it's looking good so far, so it's now it's time to obviously start working on the blocks and the stirrups. Okay, so I just took the yard back apart and I've just brought over the octagonal section of it, and I'm going to mark it up ready to fit the slings. So I'm just looking which is the best face. That one looks about the best. So I'm just going to lay on the drawing and just mark out where they've. Just check with the ruler, make sure everything's even. Got 22mm on the side. Yeah, 22mm on the side. Yes, that's okay. So I'll just glue the slings in place. Alright, so I'm just going to glue the slings in place. Just brought my glue up. The glue I use is Gorilla Wood Glue. I think it's one of the strongest wood glues you get. And all I've done is it's just an old paint pot. Just emptied it and just fill it up every time it gets empty, fill it back up again. Obviously when you've done it at the end of the day you can just keep just clip the lid. Obviously when it's empty, just fill it up. Set the slings in first and then I'll just position them better. Let's get a little cocktail stick. Just keep moving it. Until you're happy with the position. I'll just wipe off the excess glue. I've just been working on the studding sail boom. Just taping it exactly the same way as I tapered the yard. Don't see, it's been incredibly careful, it's only 3mm dowel. It had to be taped to 2mm on the end. So I just pretty much used nothing other than sandpaper. I didn't use any tools, I didn't want to snap it. But it still worked incredibly well. And a lot easier, you just get such a nice rounded taper. It's obviously the lathe spinning all the time. You're just moving the sandpaper up and down, you just get a really nice taper. And it fits really nice. To the yard, and it can sort of run out. Obviously, this is going to have a layer of paint on it. But yeah, looking really good. Really starting to take shape. I like what's here. When we start adding details to the model, just things start coming alive. Okay, so I've just tapered the second studding boom and dry fitted to the yard. And just put the yard back together. I'm just going to leave it this video at this stage for this week. I'd rather obviously have the videos a little bit shorter, but I'm not having to edit them down too much, so you kind of like just get little glimpses of what I'm doing rather than trying to show you what I'm doing. So if you join me in next week's video, I'll be painting the yard. I'll also be adding all the blocks. I recently purchased some better rigging thread. Came yesterday, so I've been waiting for this so I can start working on the blocks. And I'll also show you how I've done the stirrups. I just turned them. I had to just 0.3 brass wire, so I'll also show you that. Okay, well thank you for watching this video. I hope you're enjoying the videos. If you haven't already subscribed to the channel, if you subscribe and obviously hit the bell notification, you'll get to know every time I upload a new video. And I'll see you all next week.